Hunker down, girl.
I know, it's not gonna be a short one today.
It's a long one.
Oh my goodness.
Some stuff that I can't believe I've never made you watch.
Well,
before.
I guess today's the day.
Today's
my
day,
lucky day. This is your Christmas gift to me, then?
It's the lucky day for all of us.
Okay.
Hey, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Two Gay Mats. It's Matt Steele.
And it's Matt Palmer.
As many of you may know, Mr. Stephen Sondheim, Broadway Titan, the most brilliant human being that has ever shared the planet with us ever, has passed away. So we decided it would be a nice thing to do to have Matt Palmer react to some Stephen Sondheim things that I've never, in almost 10 years of living with each other, that I have not ever showed him.
Which is wild. I mean, I did listen to Company.
You listened to Company.
Yes.
You like Company.
Yeah, I do like Company.
And I made you watch Sunny in the Park with George, which
yes.
is...
You did.
Into the Woods, you already knew because you were in Into the Woods Junior.
Yes.
When you were but a babe.
Yes.
And
Rapunzel's Prince.
And Sweeney Todd, you saw me in a production of.
I did.
Yes.
You were great.
So thank you.
You're welcome.
So we are going to react to some more Sondheim things.
Okay.
All right, and let's get the ball rolling because these videos are very long that I'm about to show him. So my favorite Sondheim shows are Sunny in the Park with George.
Yes.
The Bible. Into the Woods, the other Bible.
Okay.
And Pacific Overtures,
oh.
Which when I tell people that it is in my top three, they're just like, oh.
Was that the one that was a flop?
It wasn't. Stephen Sondheim had just, it wasn't his biggest flop.
Okay.
It came out after a string of huge successes, Company, Follies, A Little Night Music. Mm. And then Stephen Sondheim and Hal Prince were like, you know what? Let's do something a little different. We can do whatever the hell we want. So Stephen Sondheim and Hal Prince collaborated with John Wideman to write all about the westernization of Japan. Obviously, you think of that and you think musical.
Musical, yes.
You think Broadway. Let's fill one of the biggest Broadway theaters, the Circle and the Square. Not Circle and the Square, Jesus Christ, the Winter Garden.
I was gonna say.
The audacity to mix Broadway music with traditional Japanese sounds is so incredible. Stephen Sondheim wrote a song in it called Someone in a Tree.
Okay.
And Stephen Sondheim has said on record multiple times this is his favorite thing he's ever written.
Wow.
His favorite song he's ever written. This and Opening Doors for Merrily We Roll Along are like his two favorites. I prefer this one. So that is why we are watching this one.
Okay.
Now, Pacific Overtures was recorded for Japanese television. That entire Broadway production is on YouTube. So
wow.
Please watch it. So let me give you some context for Someone in a Tree. In this point of the show, the whole first act is about how these Americans come to the shore of Japan. The Japanese have been isolated for a long, long, long time, like hundreds of years, where they have not allowed anyone from outside the country to touch the soil, to enter the country. So they've been isolated on this island for centuries. These Americans are like in their harbor or port or whatever, and they're like, what do we do? They can't have these Americans walk on their soil because they consider their soil sacred. Mm. So they come up with this idea to have them walk on these mats into this treaty house to develop some sort of like pact. And that way their feet will have not touched Japanese soil. So there is no documentation of what this meeting was like or anything. So Mako, who plays the reciter, who essentially narrates the entire show, he's like, who knows what happened in this treaty house? An old man comes on and he says, I was there, I was a child, like watching in a tree from afar. The child him comes back, and then there is a person who's like, I was also there. He was a person underneath the building in case the Americans got violent or something.
Okay.
The Japanese would like knock on the floor. This guy would pop out with a with a knife and slaughter them.
Okay.
Just in case. And so it's essentially these two entities telling the reciter of the show what happened from what they saw. And it's not much. The whole song is basically about how history is told and how history is created, how it's shaped. No one knows exactly what happened. So that's what the song's about.
Great.
No one knows what was set behind the shutters of the treaty house.
It's kind of like the room where it happened.
It is the room, very much the room where it happened.
It is.
Lin-Manuel would be very happy that you made that connection.
Oh, good. I'm happy.
It's a very, like, who lives, who dies, who tells your story this song.
Okay.
I was younger then. I was good at climbing trees. I was younger then.
on everything. Where they came and where they went, I was part of the event. I was someone in a dream. I was younger than.
He's not very young. He's
you're saying he's not 10 right here.
He's very a youthful man.
Yeah. Yes.
I love how they comment on each other's ages.
Mm.
Like, brilliant, brilliant.
Do we hear what happens, or is it just like we're commenting on our ages? Like, I'm a little lost.
Oh, it's we are commenting on the fact that we are witnessing what is happening.
Okay.
Like, the things that there's, because he's far away. He only, like, sees, like, specifics, like, oh, they have gold on their pants. They have this. That's Mark Susayers. He's so hot.
I love that you're talking to me like it's an important fact.
It's very important. And he plays all the roles that require bass notes.
Mm. I'm still a little lost. I hate to tell
you. What are you lost about?
Like, what is happening?
They are witnessing what is happening. He can only hear.
But we don't know what's happening.
Yes.
Yes.
Because
okay.
We don't know what happens, but they are a part of what is happening, essentially.
Okay.
Yes. Because this is what essentially the theme is. It's not important what is happening.
It's just that I was there.
It's just that I was there, and it's. And it's not the big pictures that happen. It's the little things that create the big pictures.
It just, this feels, okay.
You'll hear it in the lyric.
Is that coming? Because yeah. Right now we've been.
Oh, it came. It's catchy. It's the fragment, not the day. It's the pebble, not the stream. It's the ripple, not the sea. That is happening.
Uh-huh.
Not the building, but the being. See, it's the little things.
Uh-huh. You know, I hear it, yes.
Yeah. Oh.
But that's kind of...
Oh. Only cups of tea in history and someone in a tree. Yes, brilliant. Give it the Pulitzer, girls. Well, of course, Lime won the Pulitzer that year, which is also amazing. Mm. But, great writing. The visuals, Boris Aronson's video, visuals. Amazing, amazing.
Did you not feel?
No, I didn't feel whatever you're about to say.
Did you not feel that for a message that is pretty succinct, there was a lot of song leading to the succinct message?
Yes, it's a musical. That's right, how musicals but do. You could, they take one like feeling or thought and they drag it.
I mean, my understanding of musicals and especially the songs in the musicals from you is that this is like, we are moving the plot along. They're singing to, you know, serve the story, not to make a single solitary point.
No, musical like numbers can like make a point. It's just explaining like how history works and everything in one long musical number format.
Right.
Yes.
Well, I...
Let it marinate. Just let it marinate. Okay. And one day when I make you listen to the full cast recording.
Woo! Oh, that's gonna be a day.
That will be a day. Because let me tell you, darling, this is the easiest song in the show for like a newbie to digest. Because it gets... Just wait for There Is No Other Way. Classic piece of music.
I feel like it's becoming clear why this was a little bit of a letdown.
This was a little difficult for the audiences to grab. I think it got good reviews and everything. And it's just as the years have gone on, it's just like, oh no, this is top three Sondheim. I love this show so much. You have to watch the whole thing. So the next video is from a Stephen Sondheim celebration at Carnegie Hall that happened in 1992. When I was a wee young lad, before knowing all the Sondheim catalog, I knew Gypsy, West Side Story, and at this point I knew Sunny in the Park with George, and I knew Into the Woods. I knew some songs from Company, some songs from A Little Night Music, some songs from Follies and everything, but I didn't know those shows in full.
Sorry, this was in 1992 that you knew all of this?
No. This concert that I'm about to show you is from 1992.
Got it.
I got this DVD one Christmas. It had, you know, a bunch of more things in the Sondheim catalogs, a lot of things I had heard before, some things I had not. Well, there was one song in this concert from A Little Night Music that was a song that I had never heard before, and it made me be like, okay, like hearing this number, I was like, oh my God, I need to get the original cast recording of A Little Night Music, and also I need to finally get Company, get Follies, get Sweeney Todd, get all of those. So this was my impetus to really be like, I am old enough to dive more into this.
Were you like 12? How old do you think you are?
I was 13.
13, okay.
Yes, I was 13 at this moment.
All right.
And this not in 1992.
Okay.
Just one of the
That's been,
know.
Yes, that's been made clear.
I am not that old.
Is this one more plotty?
I need more plotty. Like, is it? Okay, so this song is called A Weekend in the Country, and there is definitely more plot happening in this song.
Great.
This song is all plot. So the backstory of this, there is a man, and he has a young wife who's like 18, and she's a virgin, and he's old and a widower. He is also having an affair with a woman he had an affair with years ago. Mm. This woman wants to take him for herself. So she invites him and his wife to a weekend at her estate, I guess, in Sweden, where they all live. There is also another woman who is married to a man who is also sleeping with this older woman.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, and this other woman is like in cahoots with the young girl, being like, our husbands are scum. Don't trust this one woman, Desiree.
Wow.
Mm-mm. This is the act one finale, and this is when the young woman gets the invitation and they all decide to go.
Wow.
Yes.
I feel like there's so many tributes to Stephen Sondheim. Yes.
She's a maid. Mm. She's a slut too. She's the young virgin. This song's very fast. You'll have a hard time getting the lyrics.
Great.
She may hold to be the charm that she's mad if she thinks I would be such a fool as to weekend in End of scene.
All right.
See, we're moving.
I like this. Oh, he wants to go.
Allusion to his penis.
Of course. Thank you.
This is Maureen Moore. She's incredible.
Okay. Is she the other person? The other. Oh. They're in cahoots?
Yes.
Who's she sleeping with?
No one.
No one, okay.
She's not even sleeping with her husband.
Oh, great.
But now she wants to make her husband jealous. So she's gonna say that the other people are gonna go.
Cleaning the gun is weird. We're actually gonna meet the woman. I feel like
no.
We're
no, not here.
Do you, but you do meet her in the show.
Oh yes.
Okay.
And this is the one man's very religious son. You don't need to know much about him.
Okay, all right.
For this, these purposes.
Is he going to the Weekend in the Country show?
Yes, yes.
Seems like a big trip for the whole cast.
He's the one guy's son. Well, of course we all gotta go.
Oh.
The whole cast has to go. Act two has to happen.
This is very Bravo. The whole cast has to go on the trip.
A Little Night Music is a Bravo show.
Clearly. Like, maybe this is why I'm responding to it.
Yes.
There. So much cream on stage. Yes. A lot of whites and creams.
Yes, they had a palette that they were going for the concert.
Mm. And wait, how is the maid a slut? Who does she sleep with?
Everyone.
Oh, okay. What about her husband?
Not him, but...
Okay, good.
All these butlers. Oh, that French horn. Amazing.
Wow.
Now it's usually better with staging and everything, but I just wanted to show you the version that I initially saw.
Yes.
And it was just like, oh, what is this?
I mean, that was nice. Oh, I enjoyed that.
Oh, it is just masterful.
All right. I heard a rumor that the next video is 13 minutes. So we should get started.
That rumor's correct.
It's the rumor going around.
It's the rumor I started.
You did start it.
This one you will enjoy.
Okay.
Because it is a song you have heard before.
All right.
It is a song you like.
All right.
You liked when you heard it because it is from Company.
Yes.
And you also don't need to know the context of the show to enjoy this video.
Okay.
You can understand what is happening.
Okay.
It is in the documentary of the cast recording of the musical Company, 1970. And it is essentially Elaine Stritch recording the song, The Ladies Who Lunch.
Oh, you've told me about this.
It is like the middle of the night. She is struggling to get through it. And her voice is essentially just shot because it's the middle of the night.
Yes.
And so this video is very exciting because it actually has Stephen Sondheim in it.
All right.
We're not just reacting to...
We're going to see Stephen himself, the man himself.
Yes. There we go. Feed the dog. She's doing her duty.
She looked the same the whole time she was alive.
Yes.
Okay. The ladies to lunch.
She's wearing her tights.
I mean.
What's that? What's Stephen
Sondheim? Oh.
Okay, let's check this.
Quite a hairdo he has. Is this the 70s again?
Yes,
yeah.
Baby. Oh, we're okay. Gonna take it down a half tone.
Maybe if I took my hat off, I could do it.
Iconic. It's the hat.
Change for $15. I know you do. About a half done. It has to do with the labels. You have been here for 14 hours.
I know, that shouldn't have anything to do with it. I'm well, I feel fine.
Well,
can we do this?
Sure.
Can we take it down a half tone? And then that's only three takes I'm asking for.
Oh, sure.
Pretty good.
Yeah, sure.
So we'll take it down a half tone and then do it up a half.
Sure, absolutely. I want to relax you into it. I don't mind. I'd love it in this gig. But your voice is tired. Therefore, I want to be sure that we get, you know, the permanent...
It's hard to hear as a vocalist. Taking it down half tone, but sometimes you got to do it.
And this is 1970. They can't just, like, fix it.
I know, right?
I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch. Everybody laugh. Lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch.
You can like feel her being like so careful.
I know.
Really like trying to control
every note. I'm hitting every note.
Yes.
We're not lowering this fucking again. Gosh.
Does anyone still wear a hat?
Not her, she took it
No,
off.
She got hit those notes.
Maybe if I take my hat off.
I'll drink to that. Here's to the girls who stay smart. Aren't they aghast? Rushing to their classes in optical art. Wishing it were fast.
I do like this song.
Amazing. Incredible.
It's crazy how much she's like moving and acting here, because it's like, I mean, you don't know no one's seeing this. Spoke to the vocal.
She's gotta get the acting in there. She's gotta have the energy to like hit the notes.
Yeah. Wow, she's just screaming. All right. A bossa nova moment.
It really is.
It is.
Another chance to disapprove. Another chance to bring singer.
It's like, oh no, we're speaking a little bit too much here.
And is this the take that's on the album?
No.
No, okay.
We've got a while to go.
But this is the lowered key.
Yeah,
okay.
She's a little high.
Oh, which mic are we looking at?
All of them. The ending was
Look, I have to do one more right away. Everybody's waiting for this on the record. And this just doesn't have the tension that it ought to have.
It's just classic.
That is rude. That is rude.
Can you imagine calling Elaine Stritch the flaccid?
No.
Stand by, please. Ladies for lunch, take eight.
Not eight.
Take eight.
Just do the whole thing again? My God. Is this next one the one?
You'll see.
Oh my gosh. No.
You got real sharp.
Yeah, I was gonna say, this is not the one.
Stephen Sondheim's like, nope, nope.
But it's like, why not just stop her if you know it's not going to be the take?
And maybe because they want to like meet. I'm just screaming.
Really just screaming. Yeah, but I've always done that, Steve. And I've always had dumb material. So now I got good material and I can afford to go backwards. It's not so much that my voice is tired.
Oh my gosh, Elaine, it's fine. Oh my god.
Iconic.
All right, this is the last shot.
I'm just screaming. Throw that cigarette in a room.
Does she do it? Has it gone down again? What key are we in?
Everybody laugh.
He's so mean. He's so mean.
Look, Elaine, you're sounding tired, which is, you know, quite understandable at this hour of the morning. I think we're gonna lay down an orchestral track. And tomorrow or Tuesday, you know, when we're all a little crunchy, we'll put you in over, okay?
That makes sense.
I don't know. I can't hear myself.
Because we're all getting kind of punchy. Okay?
That is not what a Broadway performer wants. They want to sing with that orchestra.
I know. But let's be real. What is this from? They showed this documentary? Is it the whole thing, like, or is this just the part they...
It's like an hour and 15 minute long.
Oh,
like,
okay.
Know, like 50 minutes, an hour.
It's tough having this out there. It's tough.
But it's a great documentary.
Really?
Like, watching it, it's so good. Couple days later.
All right.
She's got her makeup done.
Yeah, she looks great.
So here's to the girls on the go. Everybody tries. Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies.
A little sharp, but definitely more there vocal.
She's not just screaming.
Yes, exactly. Yes. There's a tone there.
For the ladies who
Oh yeah, night and day.
Yeah, yeah.
But she didn't talk that whole break. Mm-hmm. Drinking tea only.
Yep.
I get it.
Even the growls.
Yes, gotta give the growls. Christina would be proud.
The growls sound good. Sensational.
That was a good take. I want you to come in and listen to it.
Perfect. And let's hear it for the ladies. It's gotta be in there.
I'll take it.
Don't fool around with.
Oh no, I
no, we won't relay.
She's like smoking this the whole time.
Oh, yeah. So yes, things would have been better if maybe she wasn't smoking.
Yes, it feels like an idea.
Maybe they all weren't smoking indoors.
Right. It was a different time, I understand, but please, like, you could put two and two together.
Yes, well, and also, you know, she liked her drink as well at
this
point in time.
She did.
So maybe it's better she, like, cut back on
the take a little break.
Yeah, you know.
Take a break.
But we got an amazing result, iconic performance, and an iconic moment in this documentary when she's just, I'm just screaming. Like, you will see Broadway fans just tweeting that gif all the time of just, I'm just screaming whenever anything happens. And you know, when you can't hit a note when you're feeling a little vocally tired, she taught us that all you need to do is maybe take off your hat. Just, if you take off the hat, maybe you'll be able to hit the notes.
That's the thing, that always works. I just wonder, like, would she or her people not have stepped in before this documentary came out and like been like, hey, can you take that part out? Like, it's one thing.
But that's
like,
the juice, that's the meat and potatoes.
I realize, and it's one thing for having to have this happen and it's being like embarrassing or upsetting and not being able to sing with the orchestra, but like, then we're going to release that moment so it can like live on the internet forever.
Well, the internet didn't exist.
I know.
But, and also like it was, I don't know where it was like first broadcast or ever. Mm. It was like broadcast once or something and then no one saw it again until like DVDs became a thing and it was available on DVD. Now there's a Criterion like DVD edition of this whole documentary. It was a different time. Performers were a little more brutally honest with themselves. Cool. They were just like, yeah, I couldn't sing that night and everything. And Elaine Stritch, you know, has never been one to shy away from the truth.
That's true.
She was always very much like, yeah, put it out there. Put me out there.
A truth teller. We love that.
We love that. May she rest. We love her. We love Stephen Sondheim. What did you learn about Stephen Sondheim from this viewing experience?
I learned that he loves a lyric. You know, the man has a lot to say. You know, I appreciate the order in which you presented them to me. And I feel like every song got better. And I like that.
Well, Stephen Sondheim would probably be like, my best one was at the top. Thank
well,
you.
You know, I appreciate his opinion. And you know, some opinions are wrong.
One day when you listen to the full thing of Pacific Overtures, you will dislike it. But as time will go on, you will realize like, oh, Someone in a Tree is perfection.
I wonder when you imagine all of these realizations happening. Like, I don't know that they will.
And there's a long life to be lived. You are quite young.
I am.
And
that
you're
is
healthy.
True.
There's
I
a
am.
Lot more art to consume, and I will force you to consume it one day. We have a lot more Two Gay Mats and Two Gay. This is not the final season of Two Gay Mats.
This is not.
We have a lot of things that if you are a patron and you would like to request Matt Palmer to Pacific Overtures, I would love that.
You don't have to, but go to patreon.com/twogaymats if you wanna, you know, request a different video.
We never get any like musical theater requests.
That's true.
And I would love that audience.
But I can't control what people request. You wanna hear more Brandy? Let's do it. It's not up to us.
It's not up to us. The audience. I imagine the people who clicked on this video will be like, ooh, we'd love a musical theater cast recording reaction.
All right, well, a YouTube comment doesn't count, sweeties. Gotta hit that Patreon subscribe button. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Matt Palmer Music.
And it's Matt Steele.
And at 2 Gay Mats for both of us. We have a podcast. It comes out every Monday. It's called 2 Gay Mats as well, TWO. Make sure to listen to it on your favorite podcatcher. And go to patreon.com/2gaymats if you wanna request a video of your own. Who do we have to give shout outs to today, Matt Steele?
Jaleesa.
Yes.
Anna Parnell.
Yes.
Garrett.
Yes.
Montana.
Yes.
Sammy.
Yes.
We love you all.
We love you all so much. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be back soon with more 2 Gay Mats.
Bye.
Bye.